Hello, my name is Keshwani.
That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I,
Keshwani. I have been solving math problems for GRE out of this book here, practicing to take the GRE general test, the 10th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase it immediately. The problem that I'm about to solve is the one that you're going to find on page number 242, quantitative comparison question. Number 13. Let's take a look at it. They give you a little picture here, so let me reproduce it here. This is your origin. Here is a point C and 0. Here is a point 0 and B. Y coordinate is B, X coordinate is 0. Here's another point. And then we have a line that goes through that, obviously. And again, the motto is very simple. Whenever we get the chance for the dramatics, why not make full use of it? So I change the color. There we go. Voila. And we are told that the equation of the line is x plus b. It says the line y equal to x plus b is graphed on the rectangular coordinate axis, as you see here. The question simply is, which quantity is bigger, a or b over negative c? That's all they want to know. And of course, a b over negative c obviously is simply negative bc. Well, there are two ways you can solve this thing. There are two ways that you can solve this problem. Let me do it both ways, actually. One is the more of a traditional way, the classical way, the orthodox way, the geeky way, the nerdy way, the academic way, the proper way, if you like, which is only for those people who see it right away and who understand about the equation of the line and so on and so forth. This quantity that you see here, this a, what does that represent? For those of you who know what I'm talking about, it represents a slope. But what is the slope of this line? How does one find the slope? Slope is rise over run. So if you're talking about the line going through this, line going through these two points, these are the points it goes through. This is the rise, which is b, and here is your run, which of course is negative c. The slope of this line is actually b over negative c, voila, and that is your a. So this quantity equals a. All they wanted to test here to see if you knew that this quantity a is nothing but the slope of the line. That's all they want to see here. The answer is c, because these two quantities are equal to each other. Now here's another way you could have solved the problem. Let me change the color one more time. Let's do it in red. Red does not write well, so let me go back to the black. Here's my equation, here's the equation of the line. From by looking at this line here, the brown line that I drew, I can see that when x is equal to 0, y is equal to b. I'm going to put that here. When x is equal to 0, y is equal to b, comes straight from here. When x is 0, y is b. I substitute that point in this equation and we just manipulate it. Something has gone drastically wrong here. I must have written something wrong. Nope. X plus b. Ah, what I wrote is not wrong, but it's not going to get me anywhere. It's not going to get me anywhere because, as you can see, a times 0 is 0. A times 0 is 0. So this quantity is just 0, and then b equals cancel out with this b. That's not what I meant to do. I made a mistake. Let's look at a different point. Let's not look at this point. I'm not going to erase it. I'm just going to cross it out. We're not interested in this point. What I meant to say is this point. When y is equal to 0, x equals to c. This point right here. See, it does not rise at all. The y is equal to 0. When y is equal to 0, x equals c. You see, x coordinate c. I'm going to put that in here. When y equals 0, x equals c. Very good. Now it will get someplace. Subtract b from both sides. Oh, sorry. I'm not paying attention today. A times x, x equals c. There you go. Subtract b from both sides, and the b ends up here. And what are the two quantities they want us to compare? In one column they have a, so that's what I'm going to keep here, a. So let's divide both sides by c. And you can clearly see that a equals negative bc, negative b over c, which of course is same as b over negative c. Of course, this quantity is same as this quantity. When I have, whether I write 4 over negative 5 is same as writing negative 4 over 5, which of course is also same as negative 4 fifths. These are some of the small tiny things that you have to keep in mind if you're not conversant in math. Again, if you do not know the meaning of the word conversant, look it up and learn it. It just means skilled. If you've been out of touch with it, not because this is complicated, oh my god, how can I learn this thing? That's not the reason why a lot of the people have trouble here, because they've been out of the school for years and years and years, or maybe your major was something different, you didn't study too much math, and you are having some trouble with the basic concept of math. That's what you have to keep in mind here. That's what you have to learn. That's why you need the tutor and so forth to brush up on the basic things. But anyway, this is it. The answer is C. I hope you found it helpful. If you wish to get hold of me, the answer is C. If you wish to get hold of me for personal private tutoring, face-to-face tutoring, or through the internet, through internet Skype and all that, or if you wish to buy any of the solution manuals for these problems, for any of these reasons, if you need to get hold of me, please go to my website at www.prep4r4gre.com and send me an email. All right? Thanks.